speed. Eric Bischoff, beware this Thursday on Thunder.
Absolutely. I gotta think Eric Bischoff will be as far from Charlotte as possible come Thursday. He doesn't want to be in Sky Blue Country with Ric Flair. Boy, talk about 22,000 to 1. That's not good odds.
The Horsemen are going to rock the Independence Arena this Thursday night in the Nature Boys' hometown, Charlotte.
Team LWO, Juventud Guerrero, and Uncle Edgy Guerrero.
Eddie,
Freudian slip. Now they're supposed to take on the team of the cruiserweight champ Kidman and Super Calo, but we still don't know if Calo can go or not.
Well, earlier this evening on WCW Saturday Night, we were interrupted. We were told that there was a confrontation going on in the locker room area. When our cameras picked it up, Eddie Guerrero and the other members of the Latino World Order were right in the middle of a recruiting pitch to Super Calo, but Calo gave thumbs down, and then the LWO troops were turned loose by Eddie.
And we don't know. I guess we'll find out right here. Here comes the Cruiserweight champion, Kidman, but I don't see Calo.
Well, we had an update on his condition earlier, and the word was from the WCW trainer, Danny Young, that he did not expect that Super Calo would be able to come out for this matchup. But Kidman's going to go solo. He's going to go it alone. I guess this is going to be a handicap match for the reigning World Cruiserweight Champion.
Well, this guy is all fight. Make no mistake about it. When Kidman steps into the ring, he's not the biggest dog in the fight. But more often than not, he'll come out the winner. And if he has to fight two members of LWO, he will.
You know, Scott, earlier we saw that footage from last week's Thunder right here on TBS, the number one contenders matchup between Rey Mysterio Jr. and the man on the left of your screen, the youth warrior, Juventud Guerrero. Bottom line, nothing was settled between those two. The winner was to go on to Starrcade to face Kidman for the World's Cruiserweight Championship, but neither man emerged with a pinfall or a submission victory. I understand that the WCW Executive Committee is going to have meetings over the course of the next couple of days, possibly leading into Monday, and I hear that we may have word from the executive committee this Monday on Nitro as to how they're going to settle that situation, who Kidman will meet, who Kidman will defend the Cruiserweight belt against at Starrcade.
It's Juventud Guerrero and Kidman to start us off. Kidman going at it solo. Super Calo nowhere to be found here. Oh, Juventud just slapped the taste out of the mouth of Kidman, and he got it right back at Kidman. Oh, is he on fire? Oh, reversal by Juventud into the rope. Leapfrog over. Flip out by Kidman. Misses the clothesline. Juventud over. Go behind. No. Front face. Into the mini power bomb from Kidman.
Gonna roll him up here. Got the leg hooked in the two count. You know, these two have had some incredible matchups. Very memorable singles bouts. I believe this is one of the first times they've met. Well, it was going to be a tag team, but as it turns out, it's a handicap match. Kidman in an uphill struggle, one on two.
Now right here will be a perfect opportunity for Kidman to tag in Super Calo. But Super Calo is on the shelf. Compliments to that man, Juventud Guerrero, and that man, Edgy Guerrero.
Well, Eddie Guerrero. As well as the other members of the LWO. It was, what was it, 7 or 8 members on one on Calo in the locker room.
Eddie misses the clothesline into the gut. Oh, here we go. Head scissors, side headlock takeover. Double duty for Kidman, but Eddie picks back up. Oh, go behind escape by Kidman into the rope.
Oh, how about that?
Into the bulldog.
Incredible combination move by Kidman on Guerrero and Guerrero.
Oh, the head scissors takeover by Juventud. The high flyer, the great equalizer. Oh, the basement drop kick from Juventud, and now Eddie puts the boots to Kidman.
Well, referee Brady Boone is going to have his hands full trying to keep Juventud in a one-on-one situation with Kidman. That much is obvious. Double team tactics almost the entire match.
Belly to back suplex and slam from Eddie Guerrero, and now look at Juventud.
No tag was made. He came in for congratulations, I guess.
A one-man cheerleading squad. Oh, what a disappointment Juventud Guerrero is. Never thought I would see that man as part of the LWO.
And we had so much respect for the youth warrior, that never surrender attitude, the world's cruiserweight title reigns. It just seemed as if everything was really coming into place for Juventud Guerrero as a singles competitor. And then he turns around and joins Eddie Guerrero in the Latino World Order.
Tag made, and now Juventud Guerrero in there with Kidman. The fresh man, lateral press, hooks the leg, cover, two count, and it was so close.
Well, amazingly, there's still fight left in Kidman. The cruiserweight champ able to roll the shoulder that time at two and prevent the pinfall.
Front face from Juventud, now reversal by Kidman. Juventud into the ropes, oh, the kick right into the chest. Kidman just can't go. He can't go against two men the caliber of Juventud and Eddie at the same time. Nobody can.
Brainbuster dropped him on his head, goes for the pin. But what is going on here?
He broke up his own pin attempt. Juventud drags Kidman over. Oh, slingshot diving headbutt from Eddie Guerrero.
I see what that was. He's kissing up to the boss.
Yeah.
Dragging the prone body of Kidman to the corner.
Uh-oh.
So that they can administer more pain and punishment.
Kidman shoulder high, springboard crossbody from Juventud. That will do it.
Oh, they've got him here.
Lateral press hooks the leg, and Kidman kicks out.
There's still something left. I can't believe it.
I thought Kidman was done. And so did Eddie, and so did Juventud. Now they take Kidman. They're double-teaming him in the corner.
Now blatant double-teaming right in front of the official.
Come on. This is typical LWO. They just can't hack it. One-on-one. Hang on.
Could this be Pillow finally coming out to the ring? We see...
Rey Mysterio Jr. Triple extra large T-shirt and all is on the apron.
He's an LWO member, but not by choice.
He is in the corner of Kidman.
He's going to be Kidman's tag partner?
It looks like it. After what went down on Thunder, remember, Kidman came to the rescue of Ray Jr. That's a double bulldog from Kidman. Kidman needs to make the tag to Ray.
Look how close he is to the corner.
Come on, turn around, Kidman.
Reach out and make the tag. Reach out and touch somebody like Rey Mysterio Jr.
And Kidman needs to touch Ray on the best way. You be the judge. Here we go. He's getting close. There's the tag to Rey Mysterio Jr. Ray sets up on the apron. Oh, springboard drop kick took both men out.
Well, the domino effect of that springboard drop kick took both men off their feet. Both Eddie Guerrero and Juventud, and Rey Jr. is on fire with right hand.
Oh, hang on.
Oh, who is that guy? Is that the bodyguard?
It's that mysterious bodyguard of the LWO, and he got rocked by Kidman. But there's psychosis, and he's knocked out by Rey Jr. Here we go. La Parca, Rey, and Kidman are clearing house of the LWO. Oh, here we go. Here we go. Just like LWO, it's going to be 8-on-1. But Kidman and Rey Jr. are stepping for the high ground.
Well, the whole roster of the Latino World Order finally hits the ring, but the cruiserweight champ Kidman and Rey Jr. are able to avoid them.
And Edgy Guerrero living up to his name. He is hot because Kidman and Rey Jr. escaped without being throttled by the Latino World Order.
Well, the LWO did everything within their power here on Saturday night, including trying to injure Kello earlier. Let's take another look, Scott.
It's our Snickers replay of the week. Not going anywhere for a while. Grab a Snickers. Hungry? Why wait?
Juventud checks the brainbuster on Kidman, pulls him to the corner, and lets the boss take over with the diving headbutt. But then it's Rey Mysterio Jr. out of the back to take Super Kello's place and step in as Kidman's partner.
Things are not well with the...